मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज समथिंग विच इज नॉट विजुअलाइज्ड बाय अवर नेकेड आई. वी कैन नॉट सी मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स और मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो हाउ कैन वी विजुअलाइज और इमेजिन हाउ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वर्क्स? व्हाट इज इट डायरेक्शन? वी विल लर्न इन दिस वीडियो. वी रिप्रेजेंट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड थ्रू फील्ड लाइन्स और लाइन्स ऑफ फोर्स. वी एज्यूम दैट द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड direction is indicated by these lines of force, and you may have seen this kind of 2D diagrams in all the textbooks or reference material which you learn. But what is the meaning of this? What is the direction? Here you can see that direction of magnetic field outside the magnet is going from north to the south, and inside this line will be going from south to north. So how can we visualize this? If you take a bar magnet and throw some chunks of iron filings, iron powder around it, then it will get automatically aligned as per this shape. And it is from these experiments that we have been drawing diagrams like this. Okay. Another way to visualize this is we can have a compass around a magnet, and the needle of the compass will gradually adjust. If you keep the compass on different positions across this area, then it will get aligned in the direction of these lines. Now, the crowding of the lines here indicate magnetic field is stronger near the poles, and far away from pole, the lines are far away from each other, indicating weak magnetic field or magnetic force. So the same can be visible here also. More iron filing will be concentrated near the poles, and the lines of the filings will be closer to each other. As you move apart, the distance between the filings separate. If you tap the paper, then gradually these filings will align themselves in the shape of this kind of lines. The crowding here indicates strong magnetic field. This is also another indication. Now, if you directly put the filings on the magnet on a white paper, then the filings will get stick because of the magnetic force with the bar magnet. So you can avoid this by keeping the magnet below the paper. Here there is a magnet below or beneath this paper, so you can easily take away the paper or take away the magnet, so you can have the filing separate. Now, as you can see, this is not in any one direction, means it is in all the directions. Okay, there is everywhere. If you adjust properly and if you tape it, then everywhere, no area or vicinity is such that there is not magnetic field. The strength of the magnetic field may change as we go away from the poles. Now, it is also in all the directions. It is not in two dimensions. It is all around the magnet in all the directions. Okay, if you do this experiment at your home with filings, then you will be able to better understand it. What I mean to say here is that it is not just in planar direction, it is not in one plane. The magnetic field is around the entire volume of a magnet or magnetic field due to any other magnetic material. So here you can see the 3D representation of the field. Here the lines are in the all directions as indicated by iron filings here. Now, in the same way for a bar magnet we saw, in the same way we can visualize for a horseshoe magnet. Horseshoe magnet is in the shape of a U shape, which is similar to the shape of a horseshoe. So we call it horseshoe magnet. So from north to south, these kinds of lines can be mapped, and the same can be observed with the help of iron filings. Okay, so it is the same thing. Now, what about magnetic field of coil? How can we visualize? With the help of right hand thumb rule, we know that if there is a current carrying conductor and we hold our right hand in such a way that our thumb is pointing the direction of the current, then the direction of the fingers indicate the direction of the magnetic field lines. So field lines are around the conductor in circular patterns. So what can we do? If we turn the wire in form of a loop or a single turn coil, then what will happen? Now, as per right hand thumb rule, here the current is going upward. So the direction of the field is going from lower to top side here for the left part of the conductor. Now we are turning the conductor. So now on this side of the conductor, the direction of the current is going from top to bottom. So here, as per the right hand thumb rule, the direction of the field is in clockwise direction. Here it was in anti-clockwise direction. Now because of the turning, here clockwise and here anti-clockwise, both directions match with each other, and so the field inside the loop gets strengthened. Both the field adds up in the center of the loop, so we get a stronger magnetic field in between. So as you can see, stronger magnetic field is indicated by crowding of the lines. So in the center of the loop, we have a stronger magnetic field compared to the outer side. So to improve the effect of magnetic field, we use loops or coils. Now this distribution pattern of magnetic field lines is similar to field lines of a magnet. So we can say that this loop will act as a magnet. It has same field lines pattern. And as you can see, the crowding indicates it is near to the pole. A stronger magnetic field is indicated. So here also, crowding indicates a stronger magnetic field. The same experiment with iron filings can be done with coil also. In the same way, if you put a paper and take the wire from holes in the paper, then the iron filings put on the paper will adjust when you pass current through this coil. This has several turns, so magnetic field is stronger. So you can see the iron filings lining up as indicated in this diagram. Okay, so this is a closer view of the same. It is very similar. Now we indicate inductors or coils or solenoids in the form of long coils. So you can do similar kind of experiment with wire also. And this is how we represent magnetic field in a solenoid or a coil. It is similar to what we draw for a bar magnet, but in place of a magnet, we have a coil with or without a core material. The same experiment can be done in such a way that you put a core and a coil below the paper, and on the paper, if you keep the iron filings, then you will be able to see crowding of the iron filings at the pole areas and lining up of the filings as in case of a bar magnet. So here also, it is in all the directions. It is in all three dimensions. We just represent it by using two-dimensional diagrams, 2D images, but it is in all the directions around the coil as indicated by this image. Okay, so just we indicate using 2D diagrams, but the magnetic field and the force and the field lines are in all around vicinity of the coil. So this is how we can visualize magnetic field of a bar magnet, permanent magnet, or an electromagnetic coil. Thank you for watching this video.